My question is, when pluralism is encouraged in Hinduism, why does conversion occur?
You see, pluralism is very broad. So it is the good side to it. Only one thing that pluralism does not accept or will go against, strongly against, is the idea of converting people. Because you see, the pluralism says that everybody is progressing spiritually in the path that suits his own background, his family background, his cultural background, his social background. So they come from a particular tradition. Suppose they are a devout Christian family for 1,000 years. So they've got a background already to themselves. They've got a starting point of their religious journey. So pluralism says, carry on, continue to follow your Christian path or whichever path appeals to you from your background and progress to its destination. So asking people to change their paths is something that goes against the idea of pluralism. It's in fact offensive to ask people to convert or to force people to convert. Look, Hinduism will never convert people to Hinduism, and Hindus don't want to be converted to other religions. So we say we don't want to convert and we don't want to be converted. At the same time, suppose somebody insists they want to change religion. Suppose they say, no, we want to change. Does pluralism say, no, you can't. You have to be born as a Hindu, otherwise you are not Hindu. No. You must have that openness as well. I'll give you one example, a silly example, a funny one perhaps. There was a lecturer at UCL who was a Christian who was very keen to become a Hindu. You know that one?
Yeah, I know.
And he kept pestering me, saying, I want to become Hindu. I said, no, Christian, follow your Christian path. We'll take you to the same destination. Don't worry. You are on the right path. He said, no, I want to become Hindu. So I kept fighting him. He said, I want to convert. I said, no. He kept fighting again and again. And then I still kept saying, no way. No way, because I'm a real pluralist. I don't want him to change his religion. Then he came with an argument that I had to put my hands up and say, I lose, you win. He said, but suppose in my past life I was a Hindu. By mistake, I'm born in the wrong family. And I want to come back to my real family. Who are you to stop me? I say, you win, my friend. And we got him converted, actually. We don't normally like it. But the Arya Samaj movement in the South was, okay, we give you a Hindu name and you become a Hindu now. So he's become a Hindu. Not that we want him, but he was forcing himself onto us. And we are not saying, we are exclusivist. We are chosen people. Nobody can join us. We don't say that either. At the same time, we don't go out proselytizing, trying to convert people to Hinduism. This goes against the grain of pluralism. I think we must thank Vijaybai and Kantaben for putting up with us and the way we're mistreating their house. I think they deserve a special round of applause for this marvelous kind of event we're holding here. And there's something else. There was a competition taking place about Swami Vivekananda. They were looking for orators, speakers who can speak about Swami Vivekananda. And from out of the blue came a young chap from our class and won the national prize. I think he deserves a special applause, please. Pratyash, please.